It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Jones family. Buck, Leslie, Debbie, Nori, and Steve, ready for action. And the Moya family, Carol, Ed, Mary Ellen, Norma, and Leo. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. I haven't heard an ovation like that since ABC announced Howard Cosell had laryngitis. That's very good. Here's our winning family, the Jones family.
Hi, how you doing, champ?
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Buck Jones here, the head of the family. Jones family have $1,985. Mind America, all of the nice people you have with you?
I have my daughter Leslie, my daughter Debbie, my daughter-in-law Nori, and my son Steve.
Okay. Now, if you saw our show the last time we were together, we were in Fast Money, and we wanted a question. Was name something that grows fast? And the answer was weeds. Now, who got up?
Leslie.
Leslie, yeah. And was it
Steve?
Yeah. And so you were first, weren't you? Leslie said asparagus, which totally wiped me out. I couldn't. A bizarre little mind going there. And then when we came and got the second point, Steve came up. I said, name something that grows fast. He also said asparagus. And the place fell out. So after we finished the show, I said, I know they don't use narcotics. I said, where would you get that answer, asparagus? So now they're going to tell us, right?
What
is it? How is it?
Well, we all used to grow, cut asparagus every morning before we went to high school. We'd get up at 5 in the morning and cut until 7:30 and get up the next morning. And this was in Central Washington in Sunnyside.
Well, now, who owned the asparagus farm?
Well, farmers.
Different farmers.
Oh, and you got up, and is this what this is for?
That's it.
Your paperweight.
Asparagus, Richard, is a fern. And it grows from what they call a crown, which is underneath the ground. The contents of that can there could grow from 2 crowns in less than 24 hours, which will outgrow weeds.
You mean, how big would it grow in 24 hours, asparagus?
Well, you cut them when they're like 6 to 7 inches above the ground. You have kind of a knife, and you go in below the ground, and you have your bucket on your hip, and you bend down, and you...
And how, when the next time you cut them would be when?
The next morning.
And how big would they be?
Same size.
They grow 6 inches overnight?
Six to 8 inches.
Depending on the weather. In summertime, in June and July, or towards the end of June, I guess, sometimes we'd have to cut morning and afternoon because
it grows so
fast.
You realize if Mickey Rooney had eaten this as a child, he would be playing for the Lakers right now. Thank you. So you weren't as strange as we thought, were you? You're so sweet, and we're delighted to have you here. Did you ever cut asparagus?
You bet.
Did you?
Uh-huh.
So, I apologize for laughing, but it did break me up. Here's the family going to get you called the Moya. Hi, Carol. How are you?
Oh.
How you doing?
Real good.
Who have you got with you?
I brought my husband, Ed.
Uh-huh.
And my sister, Mary Ellen. My sister-in-law, Norma. And her husband, Leo.
A very neat dresser.
Yes.
So
we
are
all
you.
Are.
What have you got here?
This is what's going to happen today.
What is it?
The Jones had better watch out because the Moyas are here to win.
It's a horoscope.
Yes. This is this month's Harper's Bazaar.
Uh-huh.
And to give you just a little taste, Mary Ellen's horoscope says that...
What sign is she?
Sagittarius.
You'll have money in hand thanks to a windfall or family help. That's good.
Ed says the money outlook improves and you'll have enough for a holiday.
Oh, right here. Gemini, who's that?
Me.
A good deal of money comes in and tension dies down.
I'm very tense about money.
Yeah. Pisces, who's that?
That's Leo.
Money comes in from new sources. Well, you're either going to win here or rob a bank. I'm not sure. We welcome you here.
Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you, and Merry Christmas to you. Those are great.
Hello, Richard.
Signs. Do you believe in those signs?
Absolutely.
You do?
We'll find out.
Yeah, well, we'll see if it works. Right. Mine said, I think, avoid hurricanes and try and make friends with Ginger Rogers.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Wish both families the best of luck. Let's play the family feud. By the way, did you check your horoscope today?
No.
You didn't?
I'm a non-believer.
Well, then you're just flying blind here.
Non-believer.
Good, I checked it.
You did check
it.
It
was no good. I'm sorry.
Oh, don't
check
it.
100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a famous office building. Who got that, Carol? The light went off so quickly. Okay.
Empire State Building.
The Empire State Building. Is it there? It's number one. 44 people said it. What are you going to do?
We're going to play it.
You're going to play it. Buck, go back there in the corral. We'll see how it works out. Ed, a famous office building.
The White House.
The White House.
Oh, that's good, Ed. That was real good.
The White House.
Rockefeller Plaza, New York.
Oh, all right. We're looking for Rockefeller Plaza. Is it there? Oop, not there. That sound means a strike. You get 3 strikes. You lose control of the question. Your Jones, who are plotting at this moment, or growing asparagus, will get a chance to steal. Norma.
How about Watergate?
Watergate?
Right. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of apartments there. I don't know if there's any offices.
There's
Let's take a look. Watergate! We want a famous office building, Leo, please.
I'll try the Occidental Tower.
Okay. Is that the one here, you mean, in town?
Whatever.
Yeah.
Isn't
there one in L.A.? I think there's also one in Chicago. The old Occidental Tower. Not there. Second strike. 3 answers left here, darling.
This is a tough one for me.
Yeah. Just check and see if the note is not there. Famous office building. You got 3 seconds.
Okay,
Right now, Buck, you can do it. Buck! Probably
okay,
don't remember
that.
France, America.
America.
The Trade Towers. The Twin Trade Towers.
France, America.
America.
I need an answer, Buck.
The Twin Trade Towers.
If you can't say it, I'm not going to let you have it. Then what do you want?
Twin Trade Towers in New York.
Twin Trade Towers. Twin Trade Towers up there, Buck. You get $54. If it's not there, Moyes get the money. Twin Trade Towers. Number 2, please. Pentagon. Number 5. Oh. All right. I got a feeling this is going to be a good day. We'll be back right after this. Jones, $54. Nothing for the Moyers. Ed, I need you. Leslie. We surveyed 100 people. The top 9 answers are on the board to this question. Name a food that helps keep Americans fat.
Candy.
Candy. Candy! Number 1 answer. What are we going to
We're going to play it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. You go on back now, Ed, and we'll see how this strategy works. Debbie, you're so cute. I need a food that helps keep Americans fat.
How about potato chips?
Oh, boy, do they. Potato chips! Nori.
Uh-huh. How about ice cream?
Sure. I would think so.
No?
100 people surveyed it, and he say ice cream. You got it. 15 people said it. $55. You're doing well. Steve.
A little sour cream.
Back with the asparagus, man.
Got to have sour cream on your potatoes.
One order of sour cream. Oh. That's your first strike, Buck.
How about butter or margarine?
Pardon?
Butter or margarine.
Don't give me 2 answers. You might help them because you got to give me 1. What one?
Well, I'll say margarine.
Yeah? All right.
Good answer.
Come on, Pat.
It's up there.
Parquet. Margarine! Not there. Second strike. Leslie?
Cake.
Cake. Right now, they struck out. What are you saying?
What do you say? Tell me.
Bread.
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 Pizza.
Bread.
Spaghetti.
Need an answer, darling.
Bread.
Bread. Okay, you had some other. Actually, what were the others?
Well, we said ice cream sundaes, pizza.
Cake, pies. French fries.
Yeah, French fries. That was the one that I liked. You said bread. Bread's up there, $55 will be a very even game. If it's not there, however, the Jones get it, and they'll have way over 100. Looking for bread. Number four. Five. Seven. Eight. Number nine. I would have said Johnny and Marie. We'll be back right after this. Jones, 54. Dollar values are doubled. This could decide the winning family. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board to this question. Tell me a word or phrase Indians used in Western movies.
How?
I know how. When?
Oh. How?
What are you going to do?
We're going to play.
They're going to play. The Asparagus Gang is going to give it
a try.
Did
you repeat that? I
didn't hear it. No, I won't.
Oh, I'm...
Not even your turn. Just listen when I talk to her. How you doing?
Rugged.
I shouldn't say that because you've got the prettiest daughter, and she's right out there, isn't she?
Mm-hmm. She is.
Casey?
Casey.
Yeah, I might bring her on and introduce her to America a little later. How are you?
Very good.
Little rascal. Tell me a word or phrase
okay.
Indians used in Western movies.
Peace.
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 Peace! Does this mean the prom is off? That's your first strike.
Yeah.
Steve.
Teepee.
Aha. Right up there with sour cream. Teepee! Wow.
Come on,
Buck. Now, luckily, you do have a Western name, Buck Jones.
You bet.
This should be easy for you because you got two strikes on you now.
How about?
We got three answers left. What do you say?
Forked tongue.
Ah.
Yeah!
We are looking for man who speak with forked tongue. Not there. Hey, you can do it. You probably don't remember me. Come on over here.
Give me some answers.
Oh,
give me
some
Anything else?
Right on.
Kemosabe.
Kemosabe
is good.
Fire water.
Kemosabe.
Aha.
Is that good?
Well, that's one Indian in particular said that, did he not?
Yes.
Was that not Tonto?
Yes.
Did the others run around saying it?
No.
What does anyone know what that means?
Friend.
Friend.
Friend? Kemosabe? Means friend? Mm-hmm. You've got to have Kemosabe. Everybody needs a Kemosabe. It's hard to get into a conversation. Well, if Kemosabe's up there, you're okay because the horoscope will come true. You will be the new winning family. But Kemosabe not there. I ride over and once again announce Jones family, big heap chiefs of game. Smoke signal, looking. Hey, 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 hey.
Oh, geez.
You know it's raining now in West Covina? Kemosabe! Came through. It's working so far, the book. Let's take a look at number two. And number three. Ugg. I heard Ugg there. Little Casey, come up here, please. Bring Henry, your little friend. Come on.
I want you up here with your mama before we say goodbye. Here's the most delightful little girl. Come on, little doll. If that's not the prettiest little Christmas girl in the world, wave to America. Wave. Yeah. Now, we've got to say goodbye to everybody. We've got $54 up there, Casey, plus $1,985. Here's the kiss. I'm going to give it to you. Okay? And merry, merry Christmas, and thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Richard.
Thank you. Merry Christmas. Thank you. Merry, merry Christmas. Thank you, Larry. Baby is beautiful. Thank you. Who would play Fast Money? Us. Who's going first? Okay. Hold my hand. And as Casey goes off to the teepee, we will pause and be back right after this. And here, so I'm going to ask you five questions. You give me five answers in 15 seconds. Try and think of the most popular answer. If you and Carol get 200 points, we will be delighted to give the Moya family $5,000. 15 seconds, please. Name a vegetable you cannot eat in one bite.
Potatoes.
A character in The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, gosh. Pass.
A kitchen appliance.
A dishwasher.
Something a rich man might own.
A Cadillac.
An animal with paws.
A dog.
Turn around.
Oh, boy.
What? Yeah, all right, turn around here.
Tomorrow will be better.
No, no, don't. Now, you have to stand here. You can't do your dance now.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I don't think you'll be too upset.
I'm not doing Fast Money tomorrow.
You gave me some good answers. Wanted a vegetable you cannot eat in one bite. You said... potato, and I said potato, and our survey said 11.
Oh, boy, I thought that was
interesting. Character in The Wizard of Oz. Well, it's a very obscure film, and you had trouble with that. You blanked out on that. I'll pass, right? Thank you. Kitchen appliance, you said dishwasher, our survey said 4. You have 15. Something a rich man might own, you said Cadillac, our survey said 7, you got 22. An animal with paws, you said. A dog, our survey said. 50. Oh, 50. We have a bar, please. That's okay.
That was wonderful.
Off you go. And here's Carol. Come on, doll. I am going to ask you the same questions that I asked Mary Ellen. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear this. Your hair looks fine. Then I'll give you another, you know, you have to give me another answer if you do duplicate it.
How'd she do?
She did okay. She got 72. You need 128. And
I
you can
do
it. Right.
Sure.
I know you can do it just before Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Big positive thoughts.
Oh,
okay?
Yes.
Remind everyone, please, the answers Mary Ellen gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name a vegetable you cannot eat in one bite.
Asparagus.
A character in The Wizard of Oz.
Dorothy.
A kitchen appliance.
Egg beater.
Something a rich man might own.
A big Cadillac.
Try again.
A mansion.
An animal with paws.
A dog.
Try again.
A bear.
Turn around.
Oh no.
Vegetable you cannot eat in one bite. Oh. And for the third time in just a short space, we have asparagus. Our survey said...
I don't understand that.
We would need two members of the Jones family to say asparagus. Carrot was number one.
Oh, that's good.
Character in The Wizard of Oz, you said... Dorothy. Our survey said... Yes, you got 100. The number one answer was Tin Man.
Oh.
A kitchen appliance. You gave me the one we all want. You said... The old egg beater. Our survey said...
Oh, that's bad.
Yeah,
Mommy.
It is bad. I'll have to agree with you there. A stove or oven was the number one answer.
Okay.
Something a rich man might own. I thought you would have said a poor man, but you didn't. You said... a mansion. Our survey said... 10. You got 110. Rolls Royce was the answer to that, the number one. An animal with paws, we asked. You got 110 points. You said... a bear, our survey said...
Oh, 190.
Look, dog got 50 because dog was the number one answer.
Yes.
Don't say gosh. Every one of those points you got 119 is worth $5. You got a total of $595, okay? And we have a commercial.
Oh, that's nothing.
We're going to see you tomorrow. This family will get another chance to meet a family. Hey, have the happiest of holidays. Will you do that? We love you here on The Family Feud. Thank you.
I'm going to say a moth.
You're going to say a moth. I got to ask you this, Joe.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah, a moth.
He just won a